disappointed. Forget it. In here, life is beautiful. The girls are beautiful. Even the orchestra is beautiful.
Yeah.
A cigarette?
No. Thank you.
Deutsche Grenzkontrolle.
You know, pass me. Ah, welcome to Germany, Mr. Bradshaw. Yours? Ihre Pass, bitte. Sie waren geschäftlich in Paris?
Nein, auf einer Urlaubsreise.
Öffnen Sie bitte Ihren Koffer. Haben Sie nur diesen einen Koffer?
Ja, das ist alles.
I wish you will enjoy your stay in Germany, Mr. Bradshaw. And a most happy new year. Deutsche Grenzkontrolle!
What's in the bag? Bubbles from Paris. Perfume, silk stockings, but more than is permitted. You understand?
I guess I've done a little smuggling myself.
You are most understanding. And I would like to see to it that Berlin will open its arms to you. We begin tonight, New Year's Eve, the Kit Kat Klub, the hottest spot in all of Berlin. Telephones on every table. Girls call you, boys call you, you call them. Instant connections.
Thanks, but I still gotta find a room.
You have no room? But this is no problem. I know the finest residence in all of Berlin. Just tell Fräulein Schneider that Ernst Ludwig has recommended you.
I can't afford the finest residence in the world. I need something inexpensive.
Ah, but this is inexpensive. Very inexpensive.
Oh, I don't care if it's awful, as long as it's cheap.
But this is awful. You will love it.
Well, Fräulein Schneider?
Ah, you see, you have a new friend, Ernst Ludwig. You have a fine place to live, and you have a house. Even your first English people. Yeah, so welcome to Berlin, my friend. Welcome to Berlin.
They will pay you, and then you will pay me, yeah?
50 marks. That's my absolute limit.
Unacceptable.
If you have anything else, I don't care how small, how far from
but
the
math... for a professor, this is more suitable.
I am not a professor. Think of me as a starving author. What do you have for a starving author?
And also a poet. You have the look.
A novelist.
And you will be most famous, there is no doubt. This is your room. Here's for your clothing, and look, there is even a table for writing. Come, sit. A novelist, it reminds me when, years ago, in all my rooms, persons of real quality...
But I can still only pay 50 marks.
The room is worth 100 marks. More than 100 marks. 50. Sit. You say 50 marks. I say 100 marks. A difference of 50 marks. Why should that stand in our way? As long as the room's to let, the 50 that I will get is 50 more than I had yesterday, yeah? When you're as old as I, is anyone as old as I? What difference does it make? An offer comes, you take.
To join him for a glass of schnapps for the new year.
And a little food.
And after all, why not?
As of eyes, I'm in bed with a hot water bottle.
Ah, perhaps Herr Bradshaw.
Oh, no, no.
Another time. I wish you much muscle in the new year.
Muscle?
Jewish, it means luck.
Oh, thank you. Same to you.
I come to your Fräulein in 10 minutes. With the schnapps.
And the fruit. And now please, anything you require, knock on my door. Day or night. Also, welcome to Berlin.
Welcome to Berlin, famous novelist. Open the Remington.
Hello? Hello?
That's what you came here for.
Sitting all alone like that, you happen to catch my eye. Would you like to buy your girl a trick?
Welcome to Berlin, famous novelist.
Girl, a choice.
Absolutely.
Oh, you're an advanced. Could you speak English, please? I'm at table number 4. Tell me, please, you can't imagine how starving.
Thank you.
You know what is the trouble with English? It is not like German. It is not an exact language. Or one must memorize 50,000 words, or one cannot speak it correctly.
Either one must memorize, or one cannot speak.
Aha. Either or. The time is now finished.
I'm in no hurry.
But the lesson is 1 hour, no? And there's a pupil is waiting.
What other pupil?
No other pupil. Then I make a suggestion. I will telephone my lady friend. She will bring a friend for you. Elsa, a genuine flapper.
Not tonight.
But you have not seen this Elsa. Hot stuff, believe me. In 1 minute, I guarantee you are making a pass after her.
A pass at her.
Aha. A pass at her.
Oh, the trouble is, I've got a date tonight.
A typewriter? But what can one do with a typewriter?
Not very much lately.
Then come with me. We make a large whoopee!
For one thing, I've got a budget, and only allows for very small whoopee.
Then you are my guest. I show you the real Berlin. So come, be well acquainted with one another.
As soon as I can afford it.
It is difficult, you know, adjusting to the idea of a poor American. But I tell you something. There is no need for this poverty. Yeah? If you're willing, I show you a most excellent way to supplement your income.
Doing what?
Oh, by taking very brief trips to Paris. Perhaps a few days each time, nothing more. But it will pay you well. Extremely well.
Oh, come in!
Herr Bradshaw, there is a young lady to see you. A young lady in a fur coat.
A young lady?
Fräulein Bowl.
Bowls? Ask her to come in.
You are old friends, you and Fräulein Bowles. From London, perhaps?
From the Kit Kat Klub, last night.
Last night? Oh, you are some snappy operator.
Darling! Would you be afraid to get my bag? Oh, it's wonderful, Fräulein Schneider. All these lovely old pieces. Just put it anywhere. I'll unpack later. Unpack? But Herr Bradshaw did not mention. I'll just be here temporarily. But I am sorry. This is not possible. How much are you paying?
50 marks.
60 marks.
It is not the money.
70.
I cannot permit.
80.
The room is worth 100 marks. More than 100 marks.
80.
85. And now, please, make yourself cozy, Frau Bradshaw.
Such a to-do. I will see you Friday for the next lesson. But I tell you something. I think I am taking from you the wrong kind of lessons.
Sally, what the hell is this all about?
Would you guess I was terrified?
Were you?
What did you? Can you imagine how that would feel being thrown out twice in one day?
You mean Max?
Dear Max. And you know whose fault it was, don't you? If you hadn't come into the Kit Kat Club and been so dreadfully attractive and recited poetry.
Sally, about you staying here.
You know what I love? A spot of gin.
Gin?
You've got some. I mean, I think one must.
No, I don't have any gin.
Oh. Prairie oysters, then.
Prairie oysters?
Oh, I practically live on them. It's just a raw egg whooshed around in some Worcestershire sauce. It's heaven for a hangover.
I haven't got a hangover. That's quite a joke.
It should be. Cost me all I had. Little did I realize how soon I'd be unemployed.
What about your job at the club?
Rather complicated, you see. One of the owners of the club.
Dear Max.
People divinely intuitive. I do hope I'm not going to fall madly in love with you. Are you in the theater anyway? Oh, then you're safe. More or less, although I do think a woman can't truly be a great actress until she's had several passionate affairs and had her heart broken. I should have let Ernst pay my cab then. He's got all that money from Paris.
From Paris?
Oh, he smuggles it in for some political party.
Ernst is in politics?
You didn't know? He goes to Paris about once a month and brings back pots of money.
He has to smuggle it in.
It's terribly dangerous, but Ernst is so resourceful. He's scared that the customs people hardly ever check the bags of non-Germans. So, just before the border, he finds some innocent-looking Englishman, or American.
Oh, it's hard to imagine an American that gullible.
Halsman by Brook. It means neck and leg break. It's supposed to stop it from happening, although I doubt it does.
Look, it's about time...
Drink!
It's amazing. You know what this tastes like? Peppermint!
Oh, well, it's your toothbrush glass. I should have rinsed it.
Oh. Sally, you've got to understand...
Is this your novel? It's in German, Mein Kampf?
No, it's not my novel. I thought I should know something about German politics.
But why? You're an American! You know, I've never known a novelist. Will I be allowed to watch you work? I promise to be incredibly quiet.
I don't think I could write with someone else on the premises.
Then I'll go out when you're writing, take long, invigorating walks.
In the middle of the night? And here's another thing. I'm not a prude.
I'm not homosexual in any way. Bobby says you are.
Bobby?
One of the boys at the club. He claims he met you in London at the Nightingale Ball.
Did he say that?
He implied it.
The fact is, Bobby's simply not my type. I say, am I shocking you talking like this?
Not a bit. But it's true. You're not just saying it, hoping I'll take my bag and run screaming into the night.
The thought had occurred to me, but it's all true. However, it's not the sort of thing you necessarily go around advertising.
I guess not. And isn't that sad? Because I think people are people. I really do, Cliff, don't you? I don't think they should be made to apologize for anything they do. For instance, if I paint my fingernails green, and it just so happens I too paint them green, well, if someone should ask me why I think it's pretty, I think it's pretty. That's what I'll reply. So, if anyone should ask about you and me one day, Cliff, you have two alternatives.
Sally, I can't afford to.
Only for a day or two.
I met this perfectly marvelous girl in this truly incredible town, and she skillfully managed to talk away into my room. I've got a terrible feeling, I've said I'm done. Besides, I've only got one narrow bed.
We'll think of something.
Everybody in Berlin has a perfectly marvelous moment. Some people have two people!
Yeah.
Your second? You think I do not know what goes on here? Sailors all the time, in, out, God only knows what the neighbors think I have here. A battleship? Quite like cost, I give you warning. One sailor more, I call the police.
And if I cannot pay the rent?
The rent is due each Friday as always.
No sailor, no rent, I move. Move.
And what am I supposed to do with your room? Out of the blue, she tells me, I move. Is that gratitude? Just last week, I gave you another new mattress.
Very well. I will be out by the end of the week. Since you insist.
I insist, you insist.
And what about the sailors?
The sailors? Fräulein Kost, if you wish to continue living here, you must not let me catch you with any more sailors. You understand?
Very well. So it is the same as always.
It is not the same as always. Fräulein Kost, I put my foot down. Fräulein Kost? Fräulein Kost?
Fräulein Schneider. Good evening.
Good evening, Herr Schulz. Such a surprise.
You are occupied?
No, no. Free as a bird. Please forgive my appearance.
But it is most becoming.
Thank you.
I have got a little something from the shop.
Another little something?
This, my compliments.
So heavy. But what could it be? Pears? Last Wednesday you brought me pears. And such pears. Apples, possibly? Friday was apples.
Friday was apples.
So I cannot guess.
Just an opener.
Herr Schulz, can I believe what I see? But this is too much to accept. So rare, so costly, so luxurious. If you bought me diamonds, if you bought me pearls, if you bought me roses like some other gents might bring to other girls, it could please me more.
Looking for a not coin. A groschen. I think it holds this way.
You're looking for a groschen? I'm looking for 2 marks.
I'm writing to my mother, thanking her for the check.
Oh, finally arrived.
She says she's knitting you a sweater?
You're joking.
I started a sweater for your friend Sally.
You sent her my measurements.
The way she knits, it doesn't matter. Oh, and she says,
tell Sally to lay off the gin.
What? Where? She does not.
Listen to this.
We are all really excited about you finishing your book.
What a liar I am.
It's my fault. The rent always dragging you off to party after party.
But I like those parties. In fact, I like this whole city. It's so tacky and terrible, and everyone's having such a great time. If this were a movie, you know what would happen? A volcano would erupt, or there'd be a tidal wave.
Maybe you should write for the cinema.
As soon as I finish the novel. As soon as I start the novel.
Well, there must be something to write about.
Oh, Sally Bowles!
Of course, I told you I inspire you. The affairs of Sally, but make me ravishing and sublimely seductive so no man can resist me. Not even very handsome, rather strange young American who lets me share his room and his bed and falls desperately in love with me. This is fiction, a guaranteed bestseller.
Now all I've got to do is write it.
Oh, poor Cliff. It's my fault, I'm afraid. I am rather distracting.
You're right. Who could possibly do any writing with you around? Sally, I didn't mean
it. It's time Cliff never stayed so long with anyone.
What is it? You got better offers?
Dozens. I'm sure you've offers too.
Oh, dozens. A couple, not one.
What about that persistent Gottfried, what's his name?
Von Schwarzenbaum?
Gottfried von Schwarzenbaum. He phoned 3 times yesterday.
And I don't get it. In America, if you tell someone you're not interested in them, You don't want to talk to them. In fact, you wish they'd go the hell away. They usually take the hint. But in Europe...
Well, why didn't you give him your number?
I must have been drunk.
Well, whatever. You captivated him. I wish you could have been at that party. A fly on the wall.
It wasn't that exciting, believe me.
Well, it seems to have been exciting for Gottfried von Schwarzenbaum.
Don't go.
What?
Don't go.
Are you serious? What mosquito bell mustn't want
to? To hell with it!
What's come over you?
Maybe I like you here. I need you here. I need your hairpins on the rug.
If it's really goodbye, I can't stop you, I know. Don't go. I wear my heart on my sleeve. Don't leave.
Just think we'll be able to write uninterruptedly.
To you, I'm just another face. A more convenient place. A casual romance. But to me,
Shut up! Could we be serious for just 1 minute?
I doubt it, Cliff.
You know, this just might be the best thing that has ever happened to us.
I doubt it, Cliff.
Because the truth is, we're drifting. We have no focus to our lives. A baby can make all the difference. I know what to mean. I get a job. I'd have to. I'd stay home nights, work on the novel, wash the diapers, the whole bit. Sally, I'd be a terrific father. I love children.
This is totally crazy.
I know, but that's exactly where I thought you might go for it. Do something for me, please. Please think about it before you go see any doctor.
It would never work out.
It could. Absolutely. Anything for a buck. Prost!
Prost.
Prost!
Prost!
Prost.
But we must discuss it. We must not merely marry to humiliate Fräulein Kost.
I assure you, Fräulein, this is not the case.
But let us be honest. Had she not seen us, you would have not proposed today.
That's then tomorrow.
You mean this?
It was on my mind.
It is also impulsive.
You hesitate because you've never been married. You're frightened. But believe me, it can work wonders. How the world can change. It can change like that. Due to one little valley. See a palace rise from a tall flat. Due to one little word.
Oh, no. Thank you. Schneider. Good morning.
Good morning, Herr Schulz.
New apples, fresh off the tree, delicious. Please.
Perhaps later.
Such a party last night. Do not remember it very well. Was I that inebriated? Can you ever forgive me?
For what? A few glasses of schnapps?
I promise you, no more drinking. On our wedding day, you will be proud of me.
I am already proud of you. But as far as the wedding is concerned,
yes?
There is a problem. A new problem.
A new problem?
New to me, because I have not thought about it. But at the party last night, my eyes were opened.
Ah?
I realized that one can no longer dismiss the Nazis. They are my friends and neighbors. And how many others are there?
Of course, many. And many are communists, or socialists, or social democrats. So what is it? You wish to wait until the next election and send aside?
But if the Nazis come to power,
then you will be married to a Jew, but also a German. A German as much as anyone.
I need a license to rent my rooms if they take that away.
They will take nothing away. Fräulein Schneider, it is not always a good thing to settle for the apple lowest in the tree, the one easiest to reach. Climb up a little. It is worth it. Up there, the apples are so much more delicious.
But if I fall?
I will catch you. I promise. I feel such a tenderness for you. It is difficult to express. Are we too old for words like love?
Far too old. I am no Juliet, you are no Romeo. We must be sensible.
Live alone? How many meals have you eaten alone? 1,000? 5,000?
20,000.
Then be sensible. Governments come, governments go. How much longer can we wait? Let me kill you an orange.
I will do it.
And the old despair that was often there suddenly ceases to be. For you wake one day, look around and say, somebody wonderful married.
Oh God!
It is nothing, I assure you. Children on the way to school, mischievous children. Children young, full of mischief, you understand?
I understand.
What good's a first impression if you knew her like I do? It would change your point of view. If you could see her through my eyes, you wouldn't wonder at all. If you could see her through my eyes, I guarantee you would fall like I did when we're in public together. I hear society moan, but if they could see her through my eyes, maybe they'd leave us alone. How can I speak of her virtues? I don't know where to begin. She's clever, she's smart, oh, she reads music. She doesn't smoke or drink gin like I do, yet when we're walking together, they sneer if I'm holding her hand. But if they could see her through my eyes, maybe they'd all understand.
Thank you.
get a job?
I'll try in tomorrow.
And you'll find something, I'm sure of it. President of a bank.
They're closed for good.
I have the most marvelous news. Guess who visited me today? Bobby and Victor. They say business at the club's been way off since I left. So, guess who is making a triumphant return immediately? Isn't that heaven?
Heaven?
Think of the money, Cliff. We need it so badly.
Not that badly.
I don't understand you. Really, I don't. First you tell me I'm not going to make the trips to Paris for Ernst anymore, even though it does seem the very easiest way in the world to make money.
Or the hardest. Someday I've got to sit you down and read you a newspaper. You'll be amazed at what's going on.
You mean politics? What has that got to do with us?
Oh, you're right. Nothing has to do with this. Can't you see? If you're not against all this, you're for it, you might as well be.
Cliff, do you realize that we hardly ever laugh anymore?
Laugh?
So refreshing today with Bobby and Victor. They laugh at everything. Especially the idea of you and me in a cottage at the end of a lane. They found that hysterical.
Come in!
I told you. Oh, no, no, come in, Fräulein Schneider. Is that the fruit bowl? Is something wrong with it?
I cannot keep it.
But why?
An engagement present. But there is no engagement.
What do you mean?
We have reconsidered, Herr Schultz and I.
Fräulein, you can't give up this way.
Oh yes, I can. That is easy to say, easy for you. Fight. And if you fail, what does it matter? You pack your belongings, you move to Paris, and if you do not like Paris there, it is easy for you. But if you were me, what would you do?
Fräulein Schneider, if you marry Herr Schultz, whatever problems may come up, you'll still have each other.
All my life I have managed for myself, and it is too old a habit to change. I have battled alone, and I have survived. There was a war, and I survived. There was a revolution for one loaf of bread, but I survived. And if the Nazis come, I will survive. And if the communists come, I will still be here, renting out these rooms. For in the end, what other choice have I? This is my world.
I regret very much returning the football. It is truly magnificent. I regret everything.
Oh, Cliff, do you think I should say something to her?
What would you say?
Oh, then it'll all work itself out.
I don't think she'd believe you.
Nobody believes me today. Did you ever think that I may just be a tremendous asset to that club? Well, the fact is, they're waiting this very minute to rehearse my number, so I really must be going.
The truth is, you're going a lot farther than the Kit Kat Club.
I am.
You're going home. My home. America.
You're joking.
I'm going to sell this, the money should get us as far as Paris, then I'll cable home for steamship fare.
What are you talking about?
Leaving Berlin as soon as possible, tomorrow.
But we love it here.
Sally, wake up! The party in Berlin is over. It was lots of fun, but it's over, and it's going to get a lot worse. How can we live here? How can we raise a family?
But is America the answer, running away to America?
We are not running away. There is no place to run to. We are going home.
Well, certainly that's fine for you, but what about me, my career?
You've got a new career.
But I could work at the club for several months at least, and then in November. Oh, Cliff, I want the world for our baby. All the most elegant, expensive things.
We'll talk about it tomorrow. On the train.
Cliff, wait, we can't just uproot our lives that quickly!
Oh no? You give me 1 hour. Sit down, don't move. Or better yet, start packing. There's plenty to do. Oh, and call the club. Tell them goodbye.
Thank you.
this as a brilliant system. What are you going to make? You're going to make your life this job, any job, by sleeping with someone.
You shut up, Clint!
All this talk about your career, my God, for once in your life, face the truth about yourself.
Maybe I will. And now don't you think it's your turn?
Sally?
I have another urgent ask for you.
Sorry.
This time I pay 150 marks.
The answer is no.
But what do you want, Clifford? You are angry with me.
I am.
This is not my politics. You're sure you can understand these things.
Why, yes.
Wait. It is very important, this errand. I pay 200 marks.
Go to hell.
But this is most upsetting, Clifford. I am your close friend. So fond of.
Get your hands off!
I know you need some money. Why don't you go? Is this because of that Jew at the party?
Like this, a cabaret old show.
Herr Schultz!
Excuse me, but I have come to say goodbye.
Oh, it's nothing. A little accident. Where are you going?
I'm taking a room at the other side of the Nollendorf Platz. I think it will be easier for her. You're leaving also?
We're going home. America.
Ah, America. I've sometimes thought of going there.
Why don't you? The way things look here...
It will pass, I promise.
I hope you're right.
I know I'm right. I understand the Germans. After all, what am I? A German.
Hello.
Hello, Sally. I've come to say goodbye. Oh. All good fortune.
Herr Schultz.
I have brought a little farewell gift. Italian oranges. Delicious.
Goodbye, Herr Schultz. I wish you Mazel.
Haha, Mazel. That is what we all need.
I've been packing for you. You won't be able to find a thing. We go today to Paris, remember?
With that face?
Oh, I was in a little fight last night. Didn't you hear about it? You should see the other two guys, not a mark on them. It's about time to leave for the station. I've got the tickets.
The fact is...
Don't say it. Whatever it is. Let's just forget the last 12 hours. Forget what I said. Kit Kat Klub, forget that you've gotten even with me staying out of the way, okay? You're so cold.
You know what I'd love? A spot of chin. We've got some derby, I mean, I think one must.
First thing in the morning? How about a prairie oyster?
Chin!
That can't be good for expectant mothers. Where's your coat? Your fur coat?
I left it at the doctor's office.
Were you sick last night? Is that why you didn't come home?
Oh, darling, you're such an innocent, really. My one regret is I truly believe you've been a wonderful father. And perhaps someday you will be. Oh, yes, that's right. And if another regret, that greedy doctor, I'm going to miss my fur coat. Oh! Isn't it funny it always ends this way? Even when I do finally love someone terribly for the first time, it just isn't quite enough. I'd spoil it, Cliff. I'd run away with the first exciting thing that came along, or you would.
That's not true. I would never run away from you, for any reason. Not if there was a baby.
Oh, us together, you mean? Oh, Cliff, that's a terrible burning fit, don't you think?
It's time to leave for the train. I could go tomorrow, the next day. This is your ticket to Paris. If for any reason you decide to use it, you can reach me at the American Express office. I'll be there till Friday.
The truth is, Cliff, I've always hated Paris.
Oh, Sally, goodbye.
Cliff, dedicate your book to me!
Germany, Mr. Bradshaw, and will return soon again?
It's not very likely.
You did not find our country beautiful?
Yes, I found it beautiful.
A good journey, sir.
There was a cabaret, and there was an Emcee in a city called Berlin, in a country called Germany, and it was the end of the world. I was dancing, Sally Bowles, and then we were both fast. If you call me bienvenue, welcome. Fremde, étranger, stranger. Glücklich zu sehen, je suis enchanté.
After all, what am I? A chairman.
If you were chairman, you would understand.